To access the discharge valve and stuffing box, the piston has to be removed. Take spanner 13 from the spare bag and use it to remove the piston nut. Below the piston nut, you will find the spring washer and the flat washer. Make sure you don't lose any of the smaller parts. Twist the piston off of the piston rod and remove the discharge valve. The special washer, golden in color, can be removed by twisting and pulling. Loosen the stuffing box completely to be able to remove the piston rod from the top cylinder. You can now access the cotton graphite. Use a screwdriver to push the pieces of cotton graphite out of the top cylinder. Inspect the pieces of quality. There should be two or three pieces inside. Then remove the guide push by pushing it out with a screwdriver. Inspect the guide push on any extreme wearing. In case of any wearing of the push or the cotton graphite, replace the pieces. Now, for reassembly, retrace your tracks. Start by placing the guide push back in its position. Place the piston rod back into the cylinder top with the stuffing box already in place. This will make it easier to place back the cotton graphite in its position. Take a piece of cotton graphite, wrap it around the piston rod, and push it down with a screwdriver. Make sure that the open endings of the different pieces of cotton graphite face in a different direction than the previous. placing all the pieces of cotton graphite, push the stuffing box back into its position, turn it until it grips, don't over tighten it. Now, place back the special washer. Make sure the flat part faces the top cylinder. Put the discharge valve on the piston and place the piston back on the piston rod. Place the flat washer and the spring washer back onto the piston rod and tighten the piston knot. After tightening, review whether the valve is in the correct place. It should not be making a curve. If it is, loosen the knot slightly.